Hello everyone, TechReviewZero here with another video of Final Fantasy for Windows Phone. It is an Xbox Live enabled game, and it was released just this morning. This is the game from way back from 1987 for the original NES, and you can see here, it looks just like the old one. You probably can't see from the camera, but it is very low res, and the text is very faded, even though it looks pretty good on camera. The text just looks faded and just doesn't look good. Well, the good thing about being low res is you get to see your battery all the time without pressing the back button for that. So, and it is manual enabled, so you can multitask. And it is a very old game, so if you're used to the new physics of games, you might not be kind of used to this, but it's basically Final Fantasy 4, 5, like RPG style games. You can see you got your attack, your magic, your clothes, you get your defend, and what is this? Oh, items, and equipment. And you can also run away. And boom, it's successful. And if you guys play Pokemon, and you can see, if you go in the grass, you're gonna get caught. And basically, just pick your move. The story is basically you're just randomly put into this world of Final Fantasy, and here it shows you what your achievements are. You get your old Final Fantasy original music, and if there's a building, you just walk through it, and then you're in the town. And this is Cornelia, and this game, old games, you know, they didn't really have instruction manuals. Well, they did, but in the game, they didn't really tell you what to do. You're really in an open sandbox. Not a sandbox, but you're in an open world, and you really kind of don't know what to do. So that's one downside, but still, the game's really fun. And if you're nostalgic about your childhood, then I recommend you getting this. And there are the shops. You can get equipment for your character. And one thing, back button is the way to quit the game, so don't press that. The pause button is actually here, where it shows your character's HP. You can see here, you get your items, magic, equipment, status, formation, and configuration. And I recommend saving all the time, because if you die, it's over. It's not over, the game's not over, but you go back to the part where you first saved. So, recommend saving a lot. And in towns, you could sprint with this button. That's nice. And I have this quest. I gave these diamonds to a king. And now I have to go save his daughter so I can move on to the next continent. And here, it's not like the new Final Fantasies where you just find potions a lot. Here, you have to buy a lot, because I haven't seen any, even though these are like the first levels. So, the animations aren't that great, and the text looks even faded here too. The camera's pretty bright, but everything's dark here. See, there's no option to skip through all this. So it's an exact port, basically, and even though it is really retro, this game is a lot of fun, and I think you're gonna love, if you love RPG games, then you're gonna love this. Yeah, you get your classic Final Fantasy music. And the D-pad, the digital moving pad, it's pretty uncomfortable. You can do that, but sometimes it just feels like you're stuttering. And you get caught way too much. And since I told you there's like no way to see like the directions or where to go, so basically You're just walking around, and you don't even know which level you should be at. So, you might die a lot, and I might die right now. I'm just gonna show you what happens when you die. Never mind, I just won. Even though this looks pretty boring from my view, you're gonna love this. I don't hate it, it's just, I like the style of it, I just don't think the original one's that great. You can see, every building is able to be walked into. And I think that's the princess. Yeah. At least the story is decent, you know? And it's like Pokemon, when you go to a boss Pokemon, I'm gonna die right here, because none of my guys have any strength. And magicians, you know, they're magicians, they only have stats. Their physical attacks won't do much damage, so you're gonna have to buy your magic moves. And yeah, I just died there, and then your party was defeated, and the game restarts. So, see, you're back right at the main screen. So that's one bad part about this game. Oh, but you get your achievements here, and just like retro games, you can't really know what you did. They're all unknown unless you do them. There's an achievement guide from Windows Phone Central, so I'll put that in the description box below if you like this game. This game is $6.99 in the marketplace, and I give it a 3.5 out of 5. And thanks for watching.